Hello everyone, it's the Architects here. Today I want to show you curtain wall corners in ARCHICAD. Generally, when we place our curtain walls, when we engage corners like this, as you can see here, we don't have any common corners for this example. To create a real corner, we are going to change our curtain wall placing system. From geometry method, we are going to use this change one. And if we place something like this, as you can see, a corner frame will be created. In the 3D window, you can realize that this one, it's something special. But if you want to make this or turn this into another curtain wall corner type, we can follow two additional way. First one is this edit icon, and second one is directly changing the settings. But I suggest you to use curtain wall selection settings way, which is more predictable. If we click the frames, we will see our frame types: corner frame, boundary frame, mullion, and transom frames. As you can guess, in the corner frame options, we have these frame options. First one is this regular double frame with cap 26. And if we click that, we will see lots of options here. If you don't want to see any profile in corners, you can use this diagonal but glazed. Just click that, and we will see some settings. There are millimeters. Just click OK. But this direction is wrong. Let's flip. And in the corner, we will see only glass. But let me change the panels to glass. We are going to make them main panel. You can also get rid of the second part. There you go. It's under the custom. You can click to reset custom segments and click OK. If you still see something like this, there they look different. It must look as this facade. We will click this edit. And if we click the scheme grids, let's select them all, and we will use this system scheme. And now it behaves like as we set up in the settings menu. And as we can see here, we have our glass detail. By the way, for this example, if you don't want to see glass in the corner, well, you can change it from the frames again, from corner frame. We can use this diagonal frame with cap, and also we have sub options in this menu. We can change the cap type, as you can see here, and also we can change our frame type. Generally, they use this box profile type, so I'm gonna click this one. More options we have, but I suggest you leave it as automatic. And you can also change the material. In the sections, it seems as aluminum, but if you want to change it from the 3D, you can use this override surfaces and choose any material you want. For instance, this metal iron. Just click OK. And here we can see our changing. So interest of saving your time, I place all of them because they are same process. I didn't want to waste your time. So basically our first one is block but glazed. We have a block in the corner, but also we have glass in front of it. Floor plan looks like this. Our little box and our glass. Then we have our completed block frame. which is basically glass are inside the block frame with gap. In 3D we will only see our block, and regular double frame with gap we have, as you can see here, two additional block for this one. Yeah, this one, as you can see here, blocks are intersected. It looks like there is something wrong. As you can see, they look different. We need to give more panel offset. Let's make this 2. Yeah, it seems a little correct. If we make this 250, now it's completely fine, and we will see this in the 3D. And as we did before, we have diagonal frame with gap. We can see our diagonal frame, and we have a gap part. In the settings, we can increase our frame width like this one. Or we can change the depth of panel inset. Let's make this 0, and this is exactly finish at the same position. Basically, these were corner profile types in ARCHICAD. Now I'm going to show very important tip for you. If we click one of them, as you can see in the settings, we cannot turn this into a slope curtain wall facade. It's completely vertical. In order to make this slope, we need to separate this curtain wall panel. Therefore, I am going to create from scratch. In the options, we will see this slant angle. Let's change this to 70 and create a curtain wall like this. And I'm going to duplicate this one and rotate. And now I want to merge them together and create a new corner type. But unfortunately, these cannot be intersected as simple walls. As you can see, if I click this intersect, it isn't working. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to split doors. First, I'm going to click this one or this one. Right click, and we will see this split curtain wall. And I'm going to click our second wall, and I'm gonna click the direction I want to delete. Also, I'm going to make this for this one. And delete. Now as you can see, we have a common corner. Now the only thing we are going to do is we are going to make this first to invisible, and we are going to give second one a corner frame. So we can click edit and we can select this border or one by one and delete. Click exit. After that, same process, we will select borders, and this time I'm going to give it a corner type, which must be a suitable type, for instance this diagonal frame. Let's click OK. Or another one. We can use this one. Let's check it in the ground floor also. We will see this section. This is not true. It looks awful. And also 3D visibility is awful too. Let's fix it. To solve this problem, we are going to get rid of all of the corners. Maybe you want to delete those. just like that. You can just give more panel offset to solve this problem. To offset them, we will use 3D window from the scheme grid. We will click our edge, discrete this blue reference line, and offset inside 100 millimeters. Also, this edge. There we go. But the border was created once more. I'm gonna delete. Just like that. And now we have two separate parts, and for those separate parts I'm just going to use a simple color and give the same material for those, which was aluminum. Maybe it was here. There you go. Let's rotate 45 degrees. Or we can move this to here. I think the thickness can be reduced more. Maybe 20 centimeters or 15 centimeters. Just like this. I think doing it in the floor plan will be better and more precise. There you go. With this method you can create your sloped curtain wall with sloped corner type, and since it was created with the column tool, you can just calculate your takeoffs from the schedule menu with this schedule system. Alright guys, these were our curtain wall corner types. If you have any question or suggestions, please let me know in the comment section below. Please hit the like button if you want to see similar tutorials like this. It's also very important for the YouTube algorithms to make this channel larger, of course, for you. Thank you for watching. Until next time, have a nice day.